All of you. Now, today topic is Coach Pachulis. Coach Pachulis proposed to establish a causal relationship between pathogen and diseases. Coach Pachulis proposed by Robert Koch. Coach postulate divided by four steps: recognition, isolation, inoculation, and re-isolation. Coach postulate for correct diagnosis of diseases and its actual causal agent. Recognition. The pathogen must be found associated with disease in diseased plants. The symptoms of disease should be recorded. Next one, isolation. The pathogen should be isolated, grown in pure culture, in artificial media and natural media. The culture characteristics of the pathogen should be noted. Next one, inoculation. The pathogen of pure culture must be inoculated on healthy plants of same species / same varieties. It must be able to reproduce disease symptoms on the inoculated plant, identical to step first as recognition. Next one, re-isolation. The pathogen must be isolated from the inoculated plant in culture media. Its culture characteristics should be similar to those noted in step 2, isolation. Now, in order to learn more about the pathogen, it should be cultured. Some of the organism are obligate parasite and cannot be cultured in artificial media. Other grow really on such media in laboratory. In order to understand the pathogenic qualities of organism, it must be brought into pure culture. Required apparatuses: round-bottomed, flat-bottomed and conical flask of various volumes, rimless culture tube, petri plate of different sizes, beakers of different volume, glass rods, spirit lamp, otherwise burner, tripod stand, wire basket, funnels, muslin cloth, cotton, filter paper, chemical balance, measuring cylinders, incubator, autoclave, hot air oven, inoculation chamber, eyes surgery scalpel, inoculation needles, platinum wire loops, etc. Then sterilize the sterilization method. The prior to use all glassware and other apparatuses should be sterilized so that any kinds of contamination may be avoided. Their sterilization proposed. Next one, cleaning glassware. The glassware should be cleaned with chromic acid, that is 100 cc potassium chromate, sulfuric acid. After cleaning with chromosome acid, the glassware should be cleaned thoroughly several times with distilled sterile water. Following this, the utensils should be dried by keeping them in hot air oven. Next one, sterilization by flame. The scalpel, inoculation needles, comma glass rods, platinum wire loops, etc. should be dipped rectified spirit and then taken over the flame of spirit lamp. By doing so, the instrument are sterilized. Next one, sterilization by hot air oven. The glassware and other instruments may be sterilized by keeping them in hot air oven at 130 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Next one, sterilization by autoclave. The prepared medium should be poured either in rimless culture tube and then are plugged their mouth with cotton. Now all these things are placed in a wire basket and it is being kept in autoclave at 15 Mbps per second per inch steam pressure at least for 15 to 20 minutes. By doing so, the media and other things get sterilized. Sterilization of affected plant tissue by surface sterilization method. The infected tissue to be used as inoculum should be sterilized as follows. Apparatus required for sterilization affected plant tissue by surface: 6 beakers, 6 glass rods, 1 pair of sterilized petri plates, 6 sterilized filter paper to be covered over beakers. 6 beaker are kept in raw, each containing a glass rod, and cover with a filter paper. 1/3 of first beaker is filled up with saturated solution of boric acid. The subsequent 2 beakers of boric acid, the subsequent 2 beaker that is second and third, are filled up with distilled sterile water up to the same height, that is one third of beaker. The fourth beaker contains 0.1% solution of mercuric chloride, and the remaining fifth and sixth beaker are again filled up with distilled sterile water up to one third mark of the beakers. Now cut part of infected leaf is taken out. The infected part of diseased fruit or leaf is cut with the help of sterilized scalpel and kept in first beaker containing saturated borax solution for 10 to 15 minutes. Then after it is taken out of the first beaker with the help of glass rods and thoroughly washed in the second and third beaker containing distilled sterile water. Now the affected part of leaf is being transferred in the fourth beaker containing mercuric chloride solution only for 10 to 15 seconds. After 10 to 15 seconds, once again the infected material is thoroughly washed in fifth and sixth beaker containing distilled sterile water. Now this sterilized inoculum is being transferred in a sterilized petri plate where it is being cut in small pieces with the help of sterilized scalpel. These small pieces are being inoculated with the help of sterilized inoculation needles, either in petri plates, in culture tube containing suitable media. Precaution: during the process of sterilization method of infected parts of plant tissue, one should be very carefully. Only the surface of the part is being sterilized and the pathogen within the tissue is not affected. Next, preparation of culture tube. The rimless culture tube of hard glass used for mycological work. The period to use the tubes are cleaned with chromic acid and then thoroughly washed with distilled sterile water and kept inverted for drying. Next, the cotton plugs are used for plugging them. The cotton plug should not be very tight or very loose. By doing so, the proper aeration is maintained Now the culture medium is prepared naturally, otherwise synthetic, and poured in the tubes, filling them up to 1/4 to 1/3 of their height. The flasks containing media should also be plugged with cotton plug and kept in autoclave for sterilization. The medium may also be filled up in petri plates instead of culture tube. Next one, for growing facultative and saprophytic fungi, the under mentioned media may be used. Generally, the media are two types: natural media and synthetic media. The prepared natural media, some natural sources such as potato, oats, rice, etc. may be used. Potato dextrose agar, that is the PDA, are the example of natural media. And to prepare synthetic media, only chemical substance are utilized, that is glucose agar medium. Next, inoculation. अगोदर आपण बघितलं PDA अशा प्रकारे झालं, कशा प्रकारे आपण तो सेक्शन कट करून स्टरिलाइज कशा प्रकारे केला हे झालेले. आता याच्यानंतर इनोक्युलेशन, द ट्रान्सफर ऑफ पॅथोजन टू द कल्चर मीडियम इज नोन ॲज इनोक्युलेशन. इनोक्युलेशन मीन्स द ट्रान्सफर ऑफ पॅथोजन टू द कल्चर मीडियम इज नोन ॲज इनोक्युलेशन. First, inoculation precaution. All the operation concerning inoculation should be done in a completely sterilized chamber. The inoculation chamber fitted with ultraviolet tube should be used. The hands should be cleaned with sterilized, should be cleaned with toilet soap and then sterilized with rectified spirit. Mouth and nose should be covered with sterilized cloth. All the instruments and glassware should be completely sterilized. All precautions should be taken to avoid any kinds of contamination. The culture tubes containing media are kept in slanting position. What is meant by slanting position? उतरत्या भागाने, सो दॅट ग्रोईंग पॅथोजन कुड बी गेट द मॅक्झिमम सर्फेस ऑफ मीडियम फॉर इट्स ग्रोथ. नाऊ विथ द हेल्प ऑफ टू फिंगर्स द कॉटन प्लग इज बीइंग रिमूव्हड and with the help of sterilized inoculation needles, the inoculum is being transferred in the center of medium. Prepare to transfer of the inoculum. The medium is scratched in the center with the help of bent inoculation needle so that the pathogen is fitted in the scratch. Now the tube is again plugged and kept in incubator at desired temperature. So it's being done in the case of petri plates that the lid is removed to minimum and the inoculation is done in the center. Next one, isolation. The separation of pathogen from the host tissue is known as isolation. When infected host tissue is inoculated, the pathogen grow on the medium. This pathogen is used as inoculum and may be transferred on the media either in culture tube or in petri plates. Thus, the pathogen is isolated from the host tissue. Next one, re-isolation. The pathogen must be isolated from inoculated plant in culture media. Its culture characteristic should be similar to those noted in step 2, isolation. Thank you for watching video.